And now onto our dinosaur of the day, Altirhinus, which was a request from Dinosaur 4602, so thanks. It was an Iguanodontian ornithopod that lived in the Early Cretaceous in what is now Mongolia in the Khukhtek Formation, and it's estimated to be 21 feet, 6.5 meters long, and weigh 1.1 tons. It was an herbivore, and it had a wide mouth and a tall arch on the top of its snout, as well as a beak that could crop its food, and it had teeth to chew the food as well. Altirhinus had a wide snout, and that may have helped with grazing food on the ground. It had this gap, too, between the beak and the back teeth. This is called diastema, so that it could crop the plants and chew at the same time. The nasal arch may have helped the dinosaur to cool down or to preserve moisture or to help with its sense of smell, or it could have been used for display or also helping with communication. Altirhinus' forelimbs were about half the length of its hind limbs, and the first digit in the hands were spikes, kind of like Iguanodon's thumb spikes. These may have been used for defense or to break open seeds or fruit. The fifth digit on the hand was opposable-ish and could have helped with grabbing food a little bit. Altirhinus had thick wrist bones, and the three middle digits of the hand were wide. They could extend out, and then they ended in hoof-like bones, and that shows they could support weight. So it was bipedal and quadrupedal. It probably walked and ran on two legs and then was probably on all fours when eating food from the ground.
So like a kangaroo.
Yeah, with thumb spikes. The type species is Altirhinus curzonovi, and the genus name means high snout. The species name is in honor of paleontologist Sergei Kurzonov, who found the original specimens. They were found in 1981 during expeditions by Soviet and Mongolian scientists. Several specimens were found, different sizes and ages. There were at least five specimens, and two were juveniles. Originally, it was classified as Iguanodon orientalis, and that was described in 1952. But Iguanodon orientalis was found to be too fragmentary and not have enough features, and also be too similar to Iguanodon bernicertensis. So there was some issues with that. Also, the type specimen of Iguanodon orientalis was found to be different from the Altirhinus specimens that were found in 1981. So they could not be the same dinosaur, and David Norman named Altirhinus curzonovi in 1998. Altirhinus may have lived among Psittacosaurus and Shamosaurus, which is an ankylosaurid. For those of you who listen to our Dinosaur of the Day segment and you like it, please consider becoming a patron. We take new Dinosaur of the Day requests from our patrons and offer a bunch of other perks as well. So check out our page at patreon.com/inodino or click the link on the left.